Forky asks a question. What's Leitmotif?
I don't know.
Luckily, boys and girls, I do know. And I'm going to help my little friend Forky here. Yeah, don't you love Forky? Forky asks a question. Today we're going to talk about something a little bit different, boys and girls. We're going to talk about a little something called Leitmotif, which is different than what we've done before, okay? The last couple videos that we've done have been me teaching how to sing and how to make up songs and following in books. This is a little bit different. We're going to talk about a special kind of music that's called classical music. And as we learn about this type of music, we're going to learn about something special in classical music that is called Leitmotif. Now, what Leitmotif is, boys and girls, is something that you would hear typically if you're watching opera. Okay, so let me show you what a little bit of opera might sound like. So, boys and girls, when most kids think about opera, they think about this, and they think it sounds like this. Right? That's what most of you think of. Well, there's lots of different types of opera, but we're going to talk about a special thing inside opera that, like I said, is called Leitmotif. Now, what Leitmotif is, boys and girls, it's where a character in a musical play has their own special theme song. Now, in operas, these theme songs usually have words in them, but what we're going to talk about today is not musical words, things that are sung, but just music that's played by the orchestra. And this is what creates the Leitmotif. These are the different musical themes. So I'm going to share with you some of the musical themes that I think you will recognize. And then we're going to talk about a special musical story, a musical fairy tale, that is called Peter and the Wolf, where each character has their own special theme. So let's get started. All right, boys and girls, let me share with you Leitmotif number one. Again, you're probably gonna recognize this, so I'm gonna put the picture of what this is right up there, okay? So here we go. Here's our first Leitmotif. Check it out. You know that one, right? Bum ba 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 bum bum ba 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 bum bum ba ba bum bum. And of course, that first one, boys and girls, is Star Wars. Star Wars, boys and girls, is a special kind of movie. It's a special kind of movie that's called a space opera. Remember how we talk about opera? Okay, Star Wars is a space opera, which means that there's characters and there's music, and the music actually acts as one of the characters. And all of the really important characters have their own special theme song, their own special Leitmotif. So that one is, that song that we just heard, that's called the Star Wars main theme or the title theme, but it's still one of the characters. That's our first Leitmotif. Let's talk about a few more, okay? You know how Mr. Graff loves this guy. This is Jedi Master Yoda. And you know what? He has his own Leitmotif too, because he's really important. His Leitmotif sounds like this. Listen. Isn't that nice? It sounds mystical. It sounds magical. Because it's supposed to. So that's Yoda's Leitmotif. Kind of cool, right? Now, other characters have their own Leitmotifs as well. These guys, the fuzzy little Ewoks, they have their own Leitmotif. It's called the Parade of the Ewoks. Listen. It sounds playful and cute, right? Because they're cute. So the music matches them, okay? Their Leitmotif matches their character, okay? Pretty cool, right? I want to share two more Star Wars Leitmotifs with you. This one is the star of our newest movies. This is Rey, and she has her own Leitmotif as well. It sounds like this. Ready? Here it comes. Isn't that nice? It sounds like she's trying to find something, which she spends the whole series of movies doing, trying to find out who her parents are and who she really is. Isn't that neat, okay? So she has her own leitmotif. But I think, besides the main theme, this next leitmotif is probably the most famous in all of Star Wars. This is this guy's leitmotif. This is Darth Vader. This is called the Imperial March. Listen. It sounds big and scary, doesn't it? It does. And that's how leitmotifs work, is those leitmotifs sound and match what the character is like. Okay? So now we're going to take it a step further and we're going to start learning about a new musical story. So now, boys and girls, I'd like to introduce a new musical fairy tale for us. This is called Peter and the Wolf. And Peter and the Wolf, boys and girls, is very old. It's over 100 years old. It's been around for a long, long time. And it's a musical story that tells a story about a little boy whose name is Peter. Peter lives with his grumpy grandpapa out in the wilderness. And Peter has some animal friends. He and his animal friends like to hang out and spend time together. But along comes a big, hungry wolf. I know, it's so creepy. So Peter and his animal friends have to try to capture the wolf, okay? That's the story. Now what's neat is that the story is told completely with music played by the orchestra. And I'll show you what the orchestra looks like next week. But I want you to learn some of these leitmotifs today. So what we're going to go through is we're going to go through each character and what their leitmotif is. Now, not only does each character have their own special song, each character also has their own special instrument. And this instrument plays their leitmotif song, which is really kind of cool. So let's walk you through the main characters, okay? All right, boys and girls, let's talk about the different characters. The star of Peter and the Wolf, the main character, is a little boy. His name is Peter. Peter's about 7 years old, but he's still very, very brave. His music is played by the strings in the orchestra, the violins, the violas, the cellos, the basses. And when you hear the music, I think you'll realize that the music sounds brave, just like him. Let's listen. Hear that? Now, ready? Take your hands and kind of go like this. Brave Peter. And look this way. Look that way. Looking for trouble. Yeah, that's Brave Peter. Nice job, boys and girls. Now, Peter has a best friend. Peter's best friend is a little playful bird. See that? And this playful bird is played by the flute, which makes sense because birds kind of make those high-pitched chirping sounds, and a flute can kind of sound like that too. Let's listen to the playful bird. Hear that? Take your hands and go like this. Be the playful bird. Nice job, boys and girls. Peter has another bird friend. Peter's other friend is the lazy duck. And the lazy duck is played by a funny instrument that's called the oboe. Okay, let's listen to the lazy duck. Oh, he's so sleepy. Hear that? Ready? Let your eyes droop. The lazy duck, go like that. Yawn again. Nice job, boys and girls. That's a lazy duck. Peter has another friend who's not a bird. Peter's other friend is his sneaky cat. And the sneaky cat, boys and girls, is played by the clarinet. Let's listen to the sneaky cat's music. Ready? Hear that? Sneaky cat. Go like this. Move your hands like that. Be sneaky. Do, 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 do. Isn't that great? So those are all of Peter's friends. Peter's also spending the springtime at his grandpapa's house. His grumpy grandpa. Who here has a grumpy grandpa? So grumpy grandpa, boys and girls, is played by another strange instrument called the bassoon, okay? Now, when you hear this music, I think that you're going to realize that it sounds grumpy. Let's listen. Here's Grumpy Grandpa. Go like this. Kind of shake your fist like this. Grumpy Grandpa. Nice job, boys and girls. So, those are those characters, but now it's time for the villain. The villain of the story, boys and girls, is a big, hungry wolf. Oh no! He's played by the French horns, and his leitmotif sounds hungry and scary like this. That's a hungry wolf, ready? Bring up your claws. Go like that. Oh yeah, you can be a scary wolf. Ready? Give me a scary wolf growl. Ready, set, go. Rawr! Woo! All right, I gotta stop. That's too scary. Woo! Near the end of the story, we have some special helpers that come. They are called the Helpful Hunters. And they're played by lots of different instruments, but their most famous instrument is because they're hunters. They have their hunting rifles, and it's played by those great big kettle drums. Ready? Listen to them. Here we go. Listen. They're looking for the wolf. And then their guns go off. Listen, here comes the big drums. It sounds like fireworks. Yeah, so those are all the characters. There you go, boys and girls. So in our story, we have lots of different characters. We have brave Peter, who's played by the strings. We have the playful bird, it's played by the flute. We have the lazy duck, that's played by the oboe. We have the sneaky cat, that's played by the clarinet. We have Grumpy Grandpa, who's played by the old bassoon. We have the Hungry Wolf, that's played by the French horns. And finally, we have the Hunters, whose rifles are played by the big kettle drums. So those are all of our different characters, and they each have their own leitmotif. Okay? So there we go, boys and girls. Thank you for listening with me. Next week, what we're going to do is I'm going to show you a video of a real orchestra playing the real music. And the conductor of the orchestra, the maestro, is going to be telling the story while the musicians play. So be ready for that next week. It's going to be a lot of fun. And as always, boys and girls, keep up the good work. Booyah. Forky asks a question. What's leitmotif? I don't know. Wait, I do know. It's a character's special musical song. I learned something new. Bye-bye. 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 You can go away now. Bye-bye.